the multiverse, a prism of endless possibilities. While the MCD reviews of this universe toils away on new videos, we've plucked one from a universe where he is already ahead of the game.
Hey guys, JamesMCD's Reviews here. Welcome to another TVlog, and today we're going to be talking about What If Season 2. This is the second season of Marvel's surprise hit animated anthology series on Disney+. It continues following the Watcher as he narrates his way through the various Elseworlds of the Marvel Cinematic Universe. If you remember from the first season, they had a bunch of different sort of figureheads come together at the end and form the Guardians of the Multiverse. Some of those storylines are picked up on, but for the most part, it is back to basics sort of standalone episodes, which I greatly appreciated. But before we get too far into detail, if you guys haven't seen my video on What If Season 1, I really enjoyed it, surprisingly so. I did not expect to like it as much as I did. I think it was tied with like Loki Season 1 as like my favorite thing that they had put out on Disney Plus. And looking back at it, I still definitely like it. I think that for a first season and, you know, the creative potential that they were using, I think, could they have definitely gone further? Absolutely, but for the start to this season, just to show sort of the tip of the spear in terms of like creative possibilities, I think it was really interesting. There were some really good episodes in that bunch. The only thing that, like, I know I'm probably gonna be in the minority, but I just didn't really care for everyone, you know, coming together at the end and all the storylines crossing over. I kinda liked when everything was, you know, kind of standalone and, you know, each universe felt distinct and everything like that. But I mean, even with that, they still made it fun and entertaining and exciting and everything like that. So now, What If Season 2 comes out? They're doing a very, like, interesting release strategy where it's a new episode every single day up until the end of the year. Like, in the lead up to Christmas and New Year's, which I thought was kind of interesting, but at the same time, I imagine for a lot of YouTubers, it did not make for a super convenient, like, method in terms of, you know, breaking down each episode, because, you know, by the time they're finished with their first episode, the second episode's already out. But yeah, I got through all 9 episodes. I didn't watch it as it was coming out because I was working on my best and worst videos list. And it was back to basics What If. I enjoyed most of it. Like, not all of the episode concepts hit, but most of them were pretty solid and pretty cool looking. The animation, once again, is really great. It's very vibrant and very colorful. I mean, obviously, I'm not expecting something like Spider-Verse or anything like that. It would be cool if that were the case, but, you know, Disney Plus does not have the budget for something that ambitious. But for what it is, for like a little sort of animated side thing, like, it definitely looked cool. There were some cool scenes and some cool shots and everything like that. There were a lot of fun episode concepts this time around. I think probably my personal favorite was the Avengers forming in 1602. That I just really thought was funny just because of all the heroes. Like, one, I liked their sort of like Shakespearean era like versions of all their costumes, and also how they're like still using like sort of modern technology while also carrying around swords and shields and shit like that. I did really like the What If Kahori Reshaped the World episode. Pretty interesting. It was like a nice bit of it was kind of like a bit of MCU revisionist history, and I thought she was really cool. I liked sort of the world that they set her in, even though it was essentially like Pocahontas meets Pandora. But she was cool. I liked her power set. They didn't overplay it, which I appreciated, and I definitely think, like, given that we've now established that characters from What If can make the transition to live action with Captain Carter and Multiverse of Madness, it would be interesting to see this character, because I believe, I thought I read somewhere that she's a completely original character, so it would be cool seeing her make the transition from animation to live action and seeing her interact with like some of the other characters. I really liked the one with Hela and the Ten Rings. I thought that was really interesting, giving her sort of the Thor 1 sort of emotional journey and sort of giving her a little bit more depth and turning her into kind of a force for good. Like, and seeing her learn sort of the martial arts, like, mystic ways that was in Shang-Chi. I thought that was really cool. It made for some cool action and some cool looking animation. There was an episode that was supposed to be part of season one that was, I guess, cut and replaced and brought over to season two, the one with Tony Stark on Sakaar. That one was a lot of fun. It had some cool animation with the car racing. The one thing, I guess, with that episode is they were trying to do a whole thing of, like, showing the Gamora from that universe's sort of backstory, but, like, she just wasn't in it enough to make it feel natural. Like, she's just kind of, like, evil and has a vendetta against Tony Stark until suddenly she doesn't anymore. Some of the concepts are just kind of dumb fun. Like, there's one where literally it's just a Christmas party at Avengers Tower, and it's Happy Hogan in the plot of Die Hard, and then he turns into the Amazing Bulk. Which I guess things in multiple universes have, like, lasting consequences, because they carry that over into the 1602 episode, which was, it was weird, but it was kind of funny. I don't know how I feel about them sort of propelling Captain Carter as sort of, like, the, like, secondary figurehead of, you know, the multiverse. Like, her and Evil Doctor Strange, which are the two big ones that come back into play in this season, are, like, You figure it makes sense with Doctor Strange that he can see and talk to the Watcher and everything like that. But the fact that, like, the Watcher is so fixated on Peggy Carter in this universe, it just, I don't know, it feels kind of, like, forced. Like, it's nothing against her or the performance or whatever. It's just, she's not, like, super interesting. She's just, because it's just Captain America again, but in reverse. I mean, I did think her episode with the Black Widow and the Hydra Stomper and everything was fine, but it was just kind of, like, mid-tier for me personally. Also, when she gets, like, super powered up in the finale with, like, all the characters, like, armor and weapons and powers and everything, my girlfriend made the connection. It's like when you're in an MMO and you put on all these, like, costume pieces that don't match and look ridiculous, but they all have really good stats, so you have to use them. Like, that immediately is what we both thought of, and it was instantly hilarious. I'm like, okay, this is getting kind of stupid. The voice acting, once again, is a bit of a mixed bag. Everyone in the MCU who could come back does come back, and they range from pretty solid to kind of eh. Like, part of me does kind of wish that they didn't feel the need to, like, solely rely on the actors from the MCU movies, and that, like, this could feel like its own separate thing. But I don't know, it was still cool seeing people like Cate Blanchett come back, and, you know, Karen Gillan in that first episode, and, you know, all the various members of the Avengers that did come back. But yeah, overall, I enjoyed What If Season 2. I don't know that I really liked it as much as Season 1. I thought that there were a lot more cooler and more interesting episode concepts in Season 1. This one had some good ones too, but, like, for the most part, I was admittedly kind of just watching it out of obligation. This is kind of like the Star Wars Visions of the MCU for me in terms of Disney Plus shows, in that it's kind of the only thing that I'm, like, legitimately interested in anymore. Like, even though I wasn't, like, 100% on this season, like, I'd still really love to see where else they can take it. I mean, they've confirmed a season 3 is in the works, so, like, hopefully, like, they can use that, like, now that they've had, like, two really good, really solid seasons under their belt, like, they can use that to just explore just even crazier episode concepts. But yeah, this was a solid season. It's not, like, one of my favorites. There were some fun episodes here and there, but mostly it was just kind of, like, what you'd expect. And if I had to rate it, I'd probably give it a 3.5 out of 5. But anyway, that does it for this video. Let me know in the comments what you thought of What If Season 2. If you saw it, did you like it? Did you hate it? Where does it stack in comparison to the first one? And what are some episodes and episode concepts that you'd like to see for Season 3 going forward? Let me know that stuff down below. I've got more videos coming real soon, but until then, be sure to like, subscribe, ring the notification bell so you can stay up to date on when I'm posting. Follow me on my social media, subscribe to my main channel. Everything you need to know will be in the description. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you later.